हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड टाइम टू ऑल। आई एम चंदन कुमार प्रधान। वेलकम टू योर यूट्यूब चैनल चंदन फिजिक्स। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सिंगुलर पॉइंट्स ऑफ सेकेंड ऑर्डर लीनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस एंड देयर इम्पोर्टेंस। लेट्स बिगिन। एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ ए होमोजीनियस लीनियर सेकेंड ऑर्डर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विथ वेरिएबल कोएफिशिएंट। इज गिवन बाय a naught, which is a function of x, d square y by dx square plus a1 is a function of x, dy by dx plus a2 is a function of x, y is equal to 0. Take as equation 1. This is the differential equation. This one is the linear second order differential equation. Linear in the sense the degree of that differential equation is 1. Degree in the sense the power of highest order, and it has another term containing the multiplication of y. That's why that is the linear differential equations, and these coefficients are the function of x. That's why this is the variable coefficient, and again the result of that differential equation is 0. That's why we say it as homogeneous. In overall sense, that differential equation is an example of homogeneous linear second order differential equation with variable coefficient. In the previous video lecture, that is based upon differential equations, which the solution of the linear homogeneous second order differential equation with constant coefficients are discussed. But in this chapter, the solution of that type of differential equation is taken into consideration. That's why to find out that type of differential equation solution, we use a method. That method is known as Frobenius method. Frobenius method, that is also known as the power series solution. Power series solution of differential equation. That is the Frobenius method or the power series solution of the differential equation. With the help of this method, we can easily found out the solution of that type of differential equation, that is homogeneous linear differential equation with variable coefficient. It is the standard equation for that of second order. Why the singular point is necessary? This type of method is based upon the singular point concepts. That's why we introduce what should be the singular points of this type of differential equation. Therefore, dividing that equation 1 by a naught x, these are the constants with the function of x. We get that is d square y by dx square plus a1x by a0x dy by dx plus a2x by a0x y is equal to 0. Let equation number 2. Now we have to substitute a1x by a0x as the term p, and in place of that term we introduce the term as q. Therefore that equation is looks like d square y by dx square plus p, which is the function of x, since these two quantities are the function of x, dy by dx plus q function of x y is equal to 0. That is equation number 3. Look that of equation which is the standard. That equation is the standard or normal form. Now our aim is to find out the singular points of that given differential equation. How to find out these terms? A look towards the concept as what is the ordinary point? What is the ordinary point? Let a point as x naught is said to be ordinary. Is said to be an ordinary point. Ordinary point, or we can say it as the regular point. Of that of differential equation, that differential equation 3. What is that of condition? If p and q, that is p is a function of x and q is a function of x, both are analytic, both, or we can say these are analytic at that point x naught. Okay, let x naught be the point is said to be an ordinary point, or we can say it as the regular point of that of given differential equation, provided the condition is p and q are analytic at that point x naught. Then how we have to say that these functions as p and q are said to be analytic? For analyticity condition, a function is said to be analytic. We use a function, let f of x is said to be analytic. At that point x naught, if that function f of x, if f of x can be expand in Taylor series Taylor series expansion about that point x naught that is given by summation over n is equal to 0 to infinity f n theta derivative x naught at that point n factorial x minus x naught to the power n. That means that series is exist which is exist and converges to f of x and that series is converged. Again, what is that of analyticity? A function f of x is said to be analytic at that of given point x naught. What is that of condition? That function can be expanded in Taylor series. The Taylor series expansion formula is that. And the expansion is exist and which is converged to that of function. Then we say that function is analytic at that of given point. So, in this way we define the ordinary point. Hence, x naught is an ordinary point if a naught at x naught is not equal to 0. That is, P of x is not equal to infinity and again Q of x is not equal to infinity. Then we say x naught is an ordinary point. This is a basic introduction to that of ordinary point. Now take a look towards singular point. What is that of singular point? Singular point. A point, let x naught, is said to be singular point singular point of that of differential equation of that of differential equation 3 that differential equation. What is that of condition? If either P of x or Q of x or both are not analytic at x naught. That means either any one of these two or both these two are not analytic at that of given point, then so, at x is equal to x naught, P of x is equal to, that means P of x is tends to infinity or Q of x tends to at infinity. That's why the singular point is of two types. That's why the singular point is of two types. One is regular point, one is regular singular point. And another one is irregular singular point. Irregular singular point. Then how to define what is regular singular point and what is irregular singular point? Take a look here. What is the definition of that of regularity and irregularity on the basis of that singular point? That is A. What is that of regular singular point? How to define? Let the singular point, let x naught be the singular point of the differential equation. Differential equation from that of equation, differential equation here 3 or 2. Differential of that of differential equation 2. Is known as a regular singular point. A regular singular point. If what is that of condition? If x minus x naught into p of x and x minus x naught square into q of x are analytic at x is equal to x naught. That means that point x naught is said to be singular point, which is known as a regular singular point. What should be its condition? X minus x naught of p x and x minus x naught square q x are both analytic at x is equal to x naught. In other words, we can say if x minus x naught into p of x and x minus x naught square into q of x are not infinity at x is equal to x naught, then x is equal to x naught is a regular singular point. Okay, these are the conditions on the basis of that condition we can define that singular point is either regular or not. Then another type of singular point, that is irregular singular point. Irregular singular point. How we define irregular singular point? The point x is equal to x naught is called an irregular singular point. irregular singular point of equation 2 if x minus x naught to p of x and p of x or either any of the one or x minus x naught square q of x or both this and that are not analytic at x naught. That's why so x minus x naught p x p of x and x minus x naught square q of x are infinity at x is equal to x naught. Then when these conditions are satisfied, then x naught, that is the point, x naught is said to be is irregular singular point. So now for that of differential equation, what is that of ordinary point? That means at the point where that function is said to be analytic, this is the condition for analyticity. And then what is that of singular point? Then it is of two types, one is regular singular point and another one is irregular singular point. Now we define what is that of regular singular point condition and the condition for irregular singular point. Now we take an example through which all the theoretical concepts are fully explained. Let's see that of example. The question is find the type of singular points of that of differential equation, and the differential equation is written as this. How to get that of singular points of this type of differential equation? Here solution, here 1 minus x square y double dash minus 2 x y dash plus m whole into m plus 1 y is equal to 0. That is divide 1 minus x square, that is y double dash minus 2 x 1 minus x square y dash plus m whole into m plus 1 divided by 1 minus x square y is equal to 0. Therefore, here p of x is equal to minus 2 x divided by 1 minus x square and q of x is equal to m whole into m plus 1 divided by 1 minus x square. As already discussed, that means here x is equal to plus minus 1 are the singular points of that of equation of the equation. Therefore, we have to define that singular points is either regular or irregular. Therefore, we multiply here x minus 1 to that of p of x, x minus 1 p of x is equal to x minus 1 minus 2x divided by 1 minus x square is equal to 1 minus x divided by 1 plus x, only 2 by x divided by 1 minus x, 1 minus x square, that is 1 plus x will into 1 minus x, here minus multiplied here 1 minus x, 2 x is equal to 2 x divided by 1 plus x. That means that function is analytic at x is equal to 1. That function is analytic as we take x is equal to plus 1 here. Also, x minus 1 whole square q of x is equal to x minus 1 whole square m whole into m plus 1 divided by 1 minus x square is equal to x minus 1 whole into x minus 1 m whole into m plus 1 divided by 1 minus x 1 plus x is equal to minus x minus 1 m whole into m plus 1 divided by 1 plus x. 1 minus x, 1 minus x cancel out, taking the minus as common here. Therefore, 1 minus x, taking minus, m whole into m plus 1 divided by 1 plus x. That means our analytic at x is equal to 1. Since these are analytic at x is equal to 1, so x is equal to 1 is a regular singular point, is a regular singular point. Similarly, since x is equal to plus 1 and x is equal to minus 1, now we check at x is equal to plus 1, then we check it at x is equal to minus 1. Similarly, both x plus 1 p of x and x plus 1 square q of x are both analytic, at x is equal to minus 1. Therefore, x plus 1 whole into p of x is not infinity, and x plus 1 square q of x is also not infinity at x is equal to minus 1. Then x is equal to minus 1 is also the regular singular point, Now that differential equation has the singular point plus minus 1, these two singular points are the regular singular points. Okay, so with the help of this video lecture, we understand the concepts regarding singular points of second order linear differential equations and their importance. and a problem related to this. So with this useful and informative notes, let me wind up this session. Thank you.